Hi, my name's Lynny Yung, and I'm a hemato-oncology consultant, which means that I deal with blood cancers, predominantly myeloma, and I work from Aintree Hospital and also at Clatterbridge Cancer Centre in Liverpool. So essentially, myeloma is a serious condition of the blood and the bone marrow. So it's a type of blood and bone marrow cancer and affecting the immune system. What I tell patients is that although it is a very serious condition, it's highly treatable, although we can't cure it. So we have lots and lots of treatments in our armory right now. And quite often people can carry on their lives pretty much almost normally, even though they're on treatment. So that's really, you know, the first thing that that I tell my patients when I first see them. It's not very common, but in terms of blood cancers, we probably see about 40 or 50 new cases a year within, you know, the local hospital, say for Aintree. So it's if you take it with all the other blood cancers, which includes lymphoma and leukemia, they all make up about the fifth commonest cancer. So although each GP may only see one or two cases a year, but obviously as our treatments are improving, then there are lots of people who are living with myeloma. And so there will be patients who are living for many, many years with good quality of life on with this condition. How it presents can be very, very varied. So sometimes people have back pain or severe bony pain, and the back pain is usually the most common, and that's what takes people to see their doctor. And the warning signs that we would be asking you about if this happened, and that you should really be take things very seriously, are that if you get really bad back pain that wakes you up at night, that perhaps makes your legs feel weak, or that you feel that you're not getting good control of your bladder or your bowel function, then that really is when you should go and see a doctor or come to A&E. But quite often it's a bit of back pain that comes and goes, but doesn't really have any explanation, and gradually gets worse. Sometimes people come to see their doctor for another reason and have a blood test, and it's picked up on blood tests. And sometimes people go to other specialties, for example, the kidney doctors, because myeloma can affect the kidneys, and that's how it's picked up. Other ways that people can become diagnosed are weight loss, aches and pains, sweats and fevers, and increasing numbers of infections, which might be a bit unusual for that individual. So we all, in medicine, have to be very aware of the condition, and that the way it can present in a multitude of ways. So talking about treatments, we've said that generally it is incurable, but we can control the symptoms and the pace of the disease and its progression with our chemotherapies. So there are many, many types of treatments now available, and they can range from tablet treatment to injections, where people just need to come to hospital once or twice a week for that injection underneath the skin, to being admitted for more intensive treatments, and even a stem cell transplant in certain cases. And in general, the way that we improve our treatments as the years go on is by looking at new up and coming treatments in the context of clinical trials. So if you were fortunate enough to be diagnosed, then your specialist may talk to you about clinical trials. And really, this is an opportunity for us to get our hands on new types of treatments that may not be available yet on the wider NHS. But we know from evidence perhaps from international work that these treatments are effective, and so we would like to offer them to patients. So this may be discussed with you as part of your treatments, but I think what we need to understand is that there are many, many treatments now, different combinations, and many of them mean that people can still lead lives that are mainly out of hospital. So lots of our patients are on tablet treatments. We see them every couple of months maybe, and they're carrying on doing their work and going on with their lives. So although it is a serious diagnosis, there are lots of treatment options available.